My name is Gabriel Eckstein, and I'm a law professor at Texas A&M University. The main cause of this issue is that we just don't have enough water in the Rio Grande for all the allocations, all the wants, all the needs that both countries have for the river water. This issue is a significant concern for both the U.S. and Mexico because we have a treaty between the two countries that is supposed to allocate the waters of the Rio Grande. And the treaty, which was established in 1944, was based on conditions at that time, environmental conditions, weather conditions, climate conditions, which have since changed. So this is a major concern because under the treaty, Mexico is obligated to deliver a certain amount of water down the tributaries from its side into the Rio Grande. And in the last 20 years, it has had a lot of difficulty doing so, in large part because of climate change. And the treaty itself has not been amended or improved in any way to sort of deal with this new reality on the ground. So all of us really need to be concerned about this particular situation because of a number of factors. First of all, the people who actually live in the Rio Grande Valley on both sides, the growers, the agricultural folks, the communities, the industries in the area, they are being affected by this lack of water on a day-to-day basis. There's not enough water for all of the things that they want to do. And in fact, they're actually producing a lot of the agriculture that we as consumers enjoy. One of the projects I'm currently working on is looking at the Colorado River Basin and how they have somewhat successfully dealt with the climatic changes and the droughts that they've experienced there between U.S. and Mexico, and seeing if there's lessons that we can learn and how to apply them in the Rio Grande Basin. In particular, we're looking at terms of the treaty in terms of how they are applied to the Colorado Basin and how they might be applied to the Rio Grande in a way that addresses these challenges, climate change and water scarcity and kind of overconsumption and so on, in a way that creates space for both countries to continue to work together and continue to thrive, and for the communities in the region to continue to thrive. The solution to this dilemma is not going to be easy. It's going to take time. Both sides are actively negotiating and will need to continue cooperating with each other. Climate change, all the changes that have happened in the Rio Grande Basin region have been ongoing and are going to continue well into the future. So we have to be creative, we have to be collaborative, and we have to give and take based on the treaty, but also based on maybe amendments or modifications of the treaty.